Hi friends, in this video I'm going to explain how to create a pivot table with macro. I will be writing the code step by step and will be explaining you why that code is written. Currently I'm using this data for creation of the pivot table. This data is in a normal range form. Now I want to convert this into a dynamic table, because your source data is in a table format, a dynamic table format, managing pivot tables will be much easier. To convert a normal range to a dynamic table, the shortcut is Control L or Control T. I'm using Control L. Always make sure my table has headers is checked. So it is checked now. Say OK. The dynamic table is created and the table name is currently as table 3, and I'm changing the table name to my sales data. While creating a pivot table manually, one important step we never notice, which Excel takes care of, that is creating a pivot cache. That is very important. Pivot cache is nothing but a temporary memory stored in computer. The source data is mirror imaged into the pivot cache. But while writing the code, we need to specify that pivot cache creation into the code. Now let us see how we can start writing the code. So we know the steps how to create a manual pivot table. Same steps we will implement into the code. Now let me explain you the code step by step. We have just now discussed about pivot cache. So I need to declare a variable for pivot cache, dim PC as pivot cache. Now I need to define the pivot cache. Defining the pivot cache is nothing but defining the range or area which we are using for pivot table. So for that, set PC is equal to this workbook. Since we are creating the pivot table in this workbook, dot pivot caches dot create. So this is a method. In that method, some arguments are there. The arguments are source type. We are using different source types to create a pivot table. Currently we are using Excel database, that is nothing but a normal table or a dynamic table, comma. Now we need to give the source data. Source data is nothing but my sales data. Maybe that is the name I have created. Let me see the name of the table. Yeah, this is the name. Just let me select the table name and copy and paste here. This step creates the pivot cache. Close the bracket. Now the next step is, once basically this is creating a dialog box wherein you have selected the range and you have pressed OK. In the create pivot table dialog box, when you press OK, a new workbook is created. So we need to write a line, a statement, worksheets.add, and then automatically, if you observe, Excel selects range A3. So range A3 dot select. Now pivot cache is completely created and a sheet is created, but pivot table fields are not created, or pivot table layout is not yet created. For that, we need to declare a variable, that is dim PT as pivot table, and then we need to define the pivot table is set PT is equal to PC, because pivot table is the next level of pivot cache, dot pivot table dot create pivot table. And then we need to give the destination is nothing but active cell, comma, table name is my pivot table. Now a pivot table layout will be created. Now let us check this code. So sheet is created, and then range A3 selected, and then pivot table is created, and pivot table is named as my pivot table. The next step is dragging and dropping the fields into different areas like rows, values, filters and columns. Now let us see how we can do this in a code. For that, I need to declare a variable called pivot field. So dim pf as pivot field. Now set pf is equal to pt, because pivot field is next level of pt, pt dot pivot table pivot fields, and then I need to give the name of the pivot field, that is nothing but customer. So I'm giving customer as the field, and then pf dot orientation is nothing but where I want to put, whether I have to keep in rows, columns, filters or values. So orientation is equal to, now the list has come automatically, it is showing column data field is nothing but value field, hidden, that is not required, page field is nothing but filter field, and row field is what we now wanted to do. So now this will give us customer into the row field. Just copy and then paste down. Second is vertical, and then I need to make sure that the names are written properly. Excel, let it be into page field, that is nothing but filter field. So again paste. Now instead of customer, now I'm selecting product, and I wanted to put that into column field, product, then Excel column field, and finally another one, I wanted to put revenue into value field, revenue, and then this will be data field. Here we need to write few more lines of code. What happens when your data is, your revenue numbers are not continuously filled, if any blanks are there, by default it comes as a count. So whenever such problem happens, we need to make sure that that number converted into a sum. For that, what we do, we will go to value field settings and make that as sum. The same thing we are doing in the pivot table code. What we have tried to is pf dot function is equal to Excel sum, and then this will take care of rest of the things. That is all we are actually done with the pivot table. Now this is the code. I will share this file in the drive so that you can download and practice this pivot table. The benefit of this pivot table is, once you created this code, creating a pivot table with the same kind of data is very easy, and you can create a number of pivot tables by changing the name of the pivot table and then the changing the dimensions. Here I've selected all the fields. You can change the different dimensions and create one or two fields with a press of button, and the pivot table will be created. Now let us test this code. For that, I have created a button in the source data, create pivot table, and assign the macro. If I press the tab or button, the pivot table is created with proper values. Suppose I don't want now columns in the no field in the columns, then what I need to do, I need to go to the code and simply remove the, or make the column field code as comments. And how to write comments and what is the use of comments, I've discussed in a separate video, you can watch that. And now I'm going back to the code, removing the pivot table, and then just create pivot table. Now you can see without column I'm getting the data. Now I can create n number of pivot tables like this, and the pivot tables are created very easily and without extra effort. Only thing is, in the code you need to just define the fields, how the fields to be, and define the names. That is all you need to do, and make sure that your source data should always be a table, then you can do better job with pivot tables. Hope you understand how to create a pivot table through macro, and I'm sharing this Excel file in the drive, and the link will be in the comment section. Please download and practice, and don't forget to subscribe, and please like, share, and tell more people so that they will also get benefited. Thank you very much.